Hello everyone, I welcome you all for the third session on the VLSI lab. Today we'll be concentrating on asynchronous and synchronous flip-flop in the VLSI lab there. How to write and verify the functionality of the flip-flops. I am Mahadeva Khanderao, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Gausia College of Engineering, Ramnagaram. Before going to the topic, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon for further information or go to the description for further information. Now, let us verify the flip-flops with the help of a Verilog module there. Okay, so this is a D flip-flop program. So here we have written a synchronous D flip-flop program. So here we have D as input, reset as input, enable as input, clock as input, Q and Qn as output there. And register Q is acting like a register because it is being used inside a always block here. And since we are writing asynchronous, so if you can observe, in always block, we have passage of clock, passage of reset, and passage of enable. If it is a synchronous, there will be no reset and enable inside a always block there. Okay, now since we are doing asynchronous, we have always at passage of clock, passage of reset, and passage of enable. So begin. So first the reset condition, we have to just reset all the conditions of the flip-flop there. So when reset is 1, Q is equal to 0. Okay, if reset is 0, else if enable is 1, if reset is 0 and enable is 1, D is Q. Whatever the value of D is there, that should go to Q there. Else also, it should maintain Q as previous state, means Q, it should maintain the same state there. And so this is the functionality of the D flip-flop, what we have verified it here. Assign Qn is equal to not of Q. So since we have flip-flop as a Qn, there's a not of the Q there. So we have Qn as not of Q. So this is a D flip-flop program. We can verify it since whether it is writing or working properly or not. Since it is showing already the tick mark, it means I already verified it. Let us check it once again there. Run. Just to show you all that this program is working correctly, you can just check it out in console window if any error is there. Now there is no error. You can just check it out, tick mark in the processes window there. Okay, we have verified the D flip-flop. Now let us see the test bench of a synchronous D flip-flop. Double click on this test bench, which you already written. Now in the test bench, as we already studied that, there will be no port declaration there. So module TB is the name what I use, test bench underscore AD flip-flop. Okay, so whatever is the input declared in the main program, so D, reset, enable, clock, Q and Qn, the same order we are defining it in a test bench where inputs are acting like a registers and output are acting like a wires there. I have to instantiate that. So what is the name what we have used? ADFF. So I'm using the same ADFF and I'm numbering it as one since I'm using one number, that one. So one in the same order we have to write it, instantiation there. So one initial block is used for generating a clock pulse for a clock. Okay, just to check it out the rising edge of the information there. So in the remaining initial block, we have seen the remaining conditions. That is when reset is 1 for 300 nanoseconds, reset is 0 and enable is 1 and D is given as 0. And here for D, we have used the clock of 150 nanoseconds delay there. So which is having a toggles at 150 nanoseconds there. Why? To observe the result properly, or else we have to go on keeping the D values changed. So this is a better way to give the information for the D flip-flop as an input there for our statement. Now let us verify the synthesis for the test bench also. Now it gives an error because in the port we have not declared, so it gives an error there. There's no, we should not worry about that in the test bench. The test bench importance is that we need to verify the functionality of the flip-flop. So now let us go for the behavioral. So in source, we have to go for behavioral simulation, which means that it verifies the functionality of the whichever the model which we are writing. Now since we are verifying the D flip-flop, click on the test bench and click simulate behavioral model. Okay, now if there is no error, so you will get a result in the result window. Now you can observe here that we have got the waveforms for the D flip-flops. Okay, now let us verify it, that one, whatever the truth table what we have. Now since it is asynchronous, we can easily observe that initial, these are the clock what we have it, and reset is the initial signal what we have given, reset as 1. And since we know that it always work at the passage of the clock, we can see passage. So reset is 1 till 300 nanoseconds. You can observe 200 to 300, till it's 300. So till there it is 1. And we are not given any input for the enable and D there. That's why it is taking don't care value. Okay. Now immediately after that, if you observe, okay, the value has been checked. So if you observe the next rising edge, means immediately after the reset becomes 0, immediately the rising edge what we have, D is 0. So Q is also 0. And Q is not of that. So go to the next rising edge. So what has happened? D has become 1. So Q has become 1 there. That's the functionality of D flip-flop. Similarly, next rising edge, what is there? Again, D is 1, Q is 1. Now, observe the next rising edge, what has happened? D has become 0 and Q has become 1. So, what is the functionality of D? Whatever the input you are giving to D, it passes to the Q. So, this verifies the functionality of the D flip-flop. And now, this is the asynchronous D flip-flop. Okay. Now, let us see the T flip-flops. Asynchronous T flip-flop. Open the project. I already written that. I'll just check it out, that one. ATFF. Double click on this. ATFF. Open. Okay. So, we have stopped that simulation. So, now you can observe that asynchronous T flip-flop program has been opened there. So, T reset clock and Q and Qn are the proper ports what we have here. So, T reset clock is the input. Q and Qn are the output. Now, since Q is used inside always blocks, we are writing it as a register there. So, since it's asynchronous, reset and T is being defined inside that. So, initially, the reset is made 1, Q is 0. Else, if T is 1, the functionality of T flip-flop is verified. So, we know the expression as T is XORed with Q. Q. Else, Q is maintained as Q there. And for the always block, so assign is Qn is not of Q. So, Qn is always the toggle of the Q there. So, we are getting not of that. So, N module. So, this is the T flip-flop verification. If you want to synthesize, you can just check the synthesis of that one. Just click asynchronous T flip-flop. You can just check it out. Here it is tick mark. It means it's correct. I'll just rerun once again there to show you that T flip-flop program is correct here. So, green tick mark, we have got it. It shows that there is no error in this. Now, let us go for a test bench. Double click on that. As we already seen that, this is the test bench of the T flip-flop. All the ports, input ports are registers, output ports are wires, Q and Qn are wire. So we have instantiated with ATFF, which we have given it here, ATFF as the module name. Number one for one flip-flop, what we have. So initial statement for clock, for generating clock here with the 20 nanoseconds, we have generated that. And all the remaining conditions for the T flip-flop. So reset is 1 initially and T is 0 for 30 nanoseconds. Okay, and reset is 1. So reset has become 0 after 30 nanoseconds and T has become 1 for 500 nanoseconds. And reset is 1. And T is also 1 still. So if you observe the what is happening in the all the three possible conditions, so after that 500 nanoseconds, we are given the delay. Now let us see whether this T flip-flop functionality is working properly with the help of a simulation. So we'll go for a behavioral simulation there. So click on behavioral simulation, click on the test bench option here and go to the ISC simulator what we have here. Click simulate behavioral model. If there is no error, you can see the result window in the waveform window here. And we can observe that this is the result of a waveform window what we have for the T flip-flop. So clock is being generated in the first one. And T, you can observe for 30 nanoseconds, it is 0. Okay. And reset is 0, 1 for 30 nanoseconds. So what happened? Q was 0. But as reset becomes 0, immediately the Q value has changed. So that is the functionality of asynchronous. So importance of asynchronous, we have to understand here. So reset has become 0, but still we have not got positive rising edge of a clock, but the value of Q has changed. So this is asynchronous. So immediately when next rising edge comes, the Q value gets changed there, toggle. That's why it is called as T flip-flop. So Q has become, previously it was 1, now it has become 0 there. So next rising edge from 0, so T is 1, so Q value was 0, it becomes 1. So you can observe the Q and Q value, it is toggling every rising edge of the clock there until reset becomes 1. Now once the reset becomes 1, the value of Q is 0. Okay, so this verifies the functionality of T flip-flop there. So similarly, we have to see the result for a JK flip-flop. Now let us see the JK flip-flop for the synchronous one. File, open. Okay, I'll go to the file and open the JK flip-flop. JK flip-flop. Okay. So now let us see the JK flip-flop functionality with the help of the program and simulation there. Now let us open the JK flip-flop program here. So JK flip-flop, what we have, JK reset enable clock and Qn, Qn are the ports. So you can observe JK reset enable clock are the input, Qn, Qn are the output. As we know, Q is acting like an output port inside always block. So it is being declared as register. Now since it is synchronous, concentrate here, it is synchronous, you have not written the reset there. So that's the importance of synchronous way of writing program there. So always at positive of clock. So in synchronous, only clock is present, no other ports. So if reset is 1, Q is 0. Else if enable is 1, so functionality of JK flip-flop, as we know the JK flip-flop expression what we have, J ended with Q bar plus, K and not of K plus, not of K ended with Q there. Okay, so this is the functionality of the JK flip-flop what we have written there. Else Q is maintained as Q and assign Qn as not of Q. So now let us see the synthesis of the JK flip-flop is correct or not. So click on this JK flip-flop. Already you can see the tick mark there. I'll just run once again. So what happens here is that it shows that there is no error in this. That's why it is showing green color. Now let us go for the test bench. Double click on this. Okay. So in this double click, we can observe that test bench, we have TB, JK, FF, where there is no port. So whatever the input ports are there in JK flip-flops, JK, reset, enable, clock are defined as registers. Output is defined as wires, Q and Qn. JK flip-flop is the name what we have used it here for synchronous. JK flip-flop 1, I just used as the number there for how many flip-flops we are using there. So same order we have written it. So initial statement for clock generation and the all possible conditions. So one initial block you can observe here, we have reset as 1 for initially for 300 nanoseconds. And then reset has become 0, enable has become 1. So this is the to verify the function of JK flip-flop. But if you observe JJ is the MSB there. So we have taken the clock for 100 pulse there, 100 nanoseconds, it should toggle it. Now K is LSB, we have taken it as 50. Okay. So initial statement for J and K, it should be the same thing, except the K and J is changed there. Okay, reset is 1, reset is 1 for 300, 300, reset is 0 and enable is 1, reset is 0 and enable is 1. Here J has become 0, here K is 0. For our 100 nanoseconds, here for our 50 nanoseconds, for 100 for J and 50 for K. Just to show the result of a JK flip-flop correctly. Now let us see that whether any error is present or not. Now, as usual, you can just check it out. There is error only in the port declaration there in the synthesis. So you can see that there is no port. So no need to worry about that. Now let us see the behavioral simulation. Go to the behavioral simulation, click on the test bench and click the Xilinx ISA simulator and click on the simulator button there. Now, if there is no error in the program, you will get a proper result in the waveform window there. Okay. Now you can easily observe here waveform window of a JK flip-flop. So from 0 to 300 nanoseconds of a reset is 1. Okay. You can observe that reset is 1. That's why we are not defined any enable JK. So it is showing a don't care. Okay. 1 important analysis. Now, since we are writing a synchronous program, you can observe that here only we have got the rising edge. So now since it is rising edge, the value of Q has been updated. Before that, there was no rising edge of a clock. So it was showing don't care. So this is the difference of analyzing the asynchronous and synchronous. So in synchronous, clock edge is playing the important role there. Even though reset is 1, clock is playing important role. So when the reset has become 0, the true table of JK flip-flop need to be verified. Now let us see in the rising edge of a clock, what has happened. K is 0, J is 0, Q is 0. Okay. Because it is maintaining previous state. So previous value of rising edge is what? If you observe previous rising edge, Q is 0. That's what it is maintaining here. In next rising edge of a clock, if you observe K has become 1, J is 0. So when K is 1 means it is reset. So it is Q is 0. Next rising edge, if you observe J is 1, K is 0. It means Q becomes 1. So you can observe here Q has become 1 there. So this is the third condition. When both are 1, 1, it need to toggle. So if you observe, when both are 1, 1, J is 1, K is 1. Previously, it was 1. Now it has become 0. Previously, it was 1. Now it is becoming 0. You can observe when both are 1, 1, it is becoming 0. So in the next rising edge, what has happened again? K is 0, J is 0, Q has become 0. So this verifies the functionality of asynchronous flip-flops also synchronous. Here we have understood today about asynchronous D flip-flop, asynchronous T flip-flop, and synchronous JK flip-flop there. Okay. If you have any questions, go to the comment section, write down your questions. I'll reply to your question. Like my videos, subscribe to my channel, or click on bell icon for further notification. Thank you.